Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to start our new chapter, and this video is for standard 2 as well as for standard 3. In standard 2 maths book, this chapter is named as Introduction to Division, whereas in standard 3 book, this chapter is named as Division of Numbers. So finally we are going to start our new chapter, division. Before we start this topic, first of all we need to recall all the four basic operations in mathematics, like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. These four are the four basic operations in mathematics. Addition is denoted by plus sign, subtraction minus sign, multiplication into sign and division with this division sign. So all the above three topics you have learnt already in the previous chapters. Now we are going to start what is division. Division means dividing or sharing something in equal parts. Dividing or sharing something in equal parts. Equal parts, or we can call it division is repeated subtraction. Yes, what is division? Division is repeated subtraction. Now one by one we will go to see that how division as equal sharing. Like we are having here six apples. We are having here six apples and two girls are standing there named Soni and Moni. They both want equal number of apples for each. So how will they divide equally these six apples? Of course, the first three apples Soni will take and the another six three apples Moni will take. So the first three apples Soni has taken and the another three apples Moni has taken. So they both have shared these six apples equally amongst them. So mathematically we can write here 6 divided by 2. Total number of apples 6 and total number of girls, that is 2. So when we divide, what is our answer? 3. 3 apples here and 3 apples here. So 6 divided by 2 gives 3. After that we will see here how division as equal grouping. Yes, the previously it was division as equal sharing. Now division as equal grouping. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Total 8 stars are there and we want to keep the stars in equal groups, like equal number of stars in groups. So we have made here 2 groups and both the groups are carrying 4 stars. Group number 1 is carrying 4 stars. Group number 2 is also carrying 4 stars. So mathematically we can write it as 8, that is total number of stars, divided by 4, that is each group carries 4 stars. And in this way we get how many groups together? We get 2 groups, that is 2. So finally we can say when 8 is divided by 4 we get 2. The another form is, again there are 8 stars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Now we are going to keep 2 stars together in one group, like here 2 stars, another group 2 stars, again another group 2 stars and there is one more group having 2 stars. Now mathematically we will write 8 divided by 2, so that We can see here, in total, we have divided 8 stars into how many groups? Into 4 groups, like first group, second group, third group, and fourth group. So we can write here 8 divided by 2 gives 4. Now, we will continue this division as repeated subtraction. So, we have taken one example here, like 15 divided by 3. So, we need to find out what the answer will be. So, first one we will write 15. Then, as we need to divide it by 3, we will subtract 3 from 15. So, what we are getting here? We are getting 12. Again, from this answer, we will subtract 3. So, after that, we are getting 9. Again, from this 9, we will subtract 3. We are getting here 6. Again, we will subtract 3. We are getting here 3. And we have to repeat it once again. And finally, we are getting here 0. So, we have to continue this subtraction process of this number till we get 0 finally. Now, we have to count that how many times we have subtracted. Like this is the first time we subtracted 3, second time, third time, fourth time, and finally fifth time. So, our answer is coming here 0. So, now we need to count how many times we have subtracted. And this is 5 times. So, our answer will be here 5. So, finally 15 divided by 3 equals to 5. Here, we will see that how can we divide on number line. Yes, division using number line. The very first question that we have taken is 6 divided by 2. Now, what you have to do? You have to draw a number line. A number line that you have learnt already in the previous chapter, that how to draw number line and how to mention the numbers on that line. So, what we have done? I have drawn here a number line and 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have mentioned 10 numbers on this number line. And please see that the gapping between each number is almost equal. See, so please make sure that you draw the number line and keep the gappings equal. Now, our question is 6 divided by 2. 6 divided by 2. So, we have to start from 0. We have to start from 0 and we have to reach till 6 by jumping 2 numbers together. Why 2? Because here we have 2. So, we have started from 0. We have jumped till 2. Again 2 and again 2. And now we have reached till 6. So, we have to stop over here. Now, we have to count how many jumps we have taken. Like this is the first jump, second jump and third jump. So, total 3 jumps are there. So, our answer will be 3. Got it? Now, division statement. Suppose students, a number line is given here for you. It is already drawn for you. And you have to make the division statement. You have to write it mathematically. So, how will you go to write? See, this is a number line starting from 0 till 10. And how many jumps it is taking over here? It is taking 1, 2 and 3 jumps. Okay? And starting from 0, it is going till 9. So, this 9 we have to write at first. Then 3 numbers we are jumping. So, this will be 3 over here. And total how many jumps we have taken? 3 jumps. So, this is our answer. So this is what called a division statement. Now there are some terms used in division. Like, suppose we have an example 40 divided by 5 equals to 8. So what do we call 40? What do we call 5? And what is 8? 40 is called dividend. 40 is called dividend. And what is dividend? Number to be divided. We are going to divide this 40. So it is called dividend. 5 is known as here divisor. So what is divisor? Number which divides. Here 40 is to be divided. And who is dividing? 5 is dividing. So 5 is called as divisor. And the answer is coming 8. Like 5 8s are 40. So answer is coming 8. So this answer is known as quotient. Quotient. So what is quotient? Answer or result of division. Dear students, there are some facts and properties for division that we need to remember always. The first one is, dividing a number by 1 is always equal to the number itself. Like an example is here, 7 divided by 1 equals to 7. So we are dividing 7 by 1. So the answer is number itself, the number itself, this one. Second one is, dividing a number by itself is always equal to 1. Like 7 is divided by itself, 7. So the answer will be always 1. Third one is, dividing 0 by a number is always equal to 0. If you take 0 and divide it by any of the number, it is 7 over here, but if you divide by any number, the answer you will get always 0. The next one is, dividing a number by 0 is not possible. Now, the scene is opposite. If the number is given there and you are dividing it by 0, so this kind of division is just not possible. And my dear students, so for making division easier for you, you need to follow these properties or facts of division, and that's it. Thank you.